Okay friends, let's begin with the RIP version 2, the next further part. Now guys, till now we have seen RIP version 1, correct? We saw the limitations of RIP version 1. Now this is a topology guys which you have already done, correct? Now we saw the RIP version limitations. What are they? Like classical learning protocols have 3 major limitations. What are they? First, they don't support discontinuous networks. It does not support VLSM and CIDR, correct? And again, one thing, in the updates they don't send the subnet mask, correct? Now, instead of just memorizing this fact, we'll learn them, we'll understand how they do actually, what is happening. Now guys, RIP version 2 is a category of same RIP version 1 distance vector routing protocol, but it is a classless routing protocol. When you define RIP version 1 is a classless and RIP version 2 as a classless. It is less popular but compared to like EIGRP and OSF. Compared to them, it is less popular. Because why? Other features are all same, what RIP is having. Hop counts, the periodic updates, hold on timer, invalid timer, everything is same. Only the difference is what? It supports CIDR, VLSM and classes routing protocols. Otherwise the behavior is same like RIP version 1. Okay? So, let's see the differences guys, of both of them. The enhancement what they have done in RIP version 2 is what? In the routing updates, RIP version 2 sends the your next hop address, it sends your subnet mask. Okay? And there is someone concept something called as, you know guys, RIP updates version 1 are set on your broadcast address, correct? 255.255.255.255. You know guys, RIP version 1 sends the updates on broadcast address, that is 255.255.255.255. So it goes to everyone. So it should go on your LAN network also. So when we used to make the passive interface, remember guys, on your LAN interfaces. But in RIP version 2, the updates are sent on the multicast address. Multicast address is 224.0.0.9. This is the multicast address of RIP. And there is one more feature, that is your authentication that you see at the end of your RIP version 2 guys, okay. So some new features, okay. So both versions of RIP share the following features. What are they? Hold on timer and invalid timer and the flush timers. Speed horizon, simple speed horizon and speed horizon with poison reverse. So these rules are same for RIP, both the RIPs. They send the trigger updates, yeah. And maximum hop counts of 15 hops. Okay guys. Now, this topology which you have already done, remember guys. Now we have added some more loopbacks over here. We'll do the same thing in our lab also. We are already having 100.1 and 200. Okay, they have just changed the topology guys. So let's do some modification on R3. Let me do it as per this requirement. What loopbacks I am having and what they want actually. Okay. So let's do it slowly. Let me check what I am having actually. Do show IP INT brief. I got loopback 1, that is 100.1/24. That is okay guys. Now loopback 2, I need to change the IP address, it is 200.33. So interface loopback 2, no IP address, IP address 172.30.200. What it is? They are saying 32, so there is a network ID, I'll make it 33. And /28, that is how much guys? 255.255.240, correct? 28 means 4 bits, so 240. Then next interface loopback 3, I want to make some 2 more loopbacks. See this, 200.16 and 110.0. So IP address 172.30.110.1/255.255.255.0 as it is /24. I want to make one more loopback interface, loopback 4, IP address 172.30.200.17, where 16 is my network ID, correct? So that is the next IP address, 255.255.240. Okay guys, so do show IP INT brief. So even if I make 4 loopbacks guys, when I configure RIP, I just need to configure what? See, when I configure RIP guys, the RIP is already running over here in this topology. It is just 132.30.0.0, correct guys? See, even if I got 4 loopbacks with different subnet masks, it is 132.30.0.0. Okay, so after all, it's a classful behavior of RIP, correct? It messes /16. So this is what is the problem now guys we are facing over here. R1 and R3 both sending them as /16 to R2. Okay, now in this scenario guys, I'm going to put something new over here. On R2, I'm having one static route. Okay, one summary static route to a network. See this network guys. 192 is class C, correct? 192.168.0.0/16. So guys, something different, correct? So this is something major network I am summarizing. See, these are networks. Major summarizing them to /16. But I have one route to that network. Actually, this network doesn't exist actually, guys, okay? This network is not existing, but I have one route for this network. So let's see what's happened over here. Now guys, class 4 routing protocols do not include enough routing information to route properly for discontinuous network. They do not have enough routing information like the subnet marks and all this stuff, okay? So now, and for our scenario guys, so just to make it more easier for you to understand the RIP version 1 limitations, we have got one routes to this one network. See this IP route, a static route. What is null zero guys says over here? This says IP route to any network that is 192.168.0.0/16 packets should be dropped. Null zero means what? Drop the packets. If someone start to ping this network, drop the packets. But I have one route over there, but I have one routes for this network guys, okay? But see this, is it classful? No, this class is something different. This is called as guys manual summarization. This is what? Manual summarization, correct? This is manual summarization. I'm making /16. But it is, but is this manual summarization supported in RIP version 1? That we need to see guys. Okay? That's why I'm putting this route over here. Okay. And what I'm doing, I'm going to redistribute that static route into my RIP updates. Injecting static routes into routing protocol updates. Okay guys. Remember guys, in the previous topology RIP version 1, I had a static route over here. Remember? Default route. I said over here default information originate. What it did? It sent my default route as a RIP updates to my neighbor RIP routers, correct? But over here I'm going to do redistribute. I'm going to redistribute this static route into my RIP updates. So now we need to see, does this happens or it doesn't happens. Okay? So guys, this is a command redistribute static. That's it. So let's do it guys, okay? This is what? This is a supernetting. What is supernetting? Combining of all small networks and making it a one network, correct? What is subnetting? Breaking one network into small subnets. What is supernet? Reverse of that. Combine all small networks and make one big network. Show as one single network, correct? So let me go on R2 and let's do this stuff guys, okay? Connect. I say IP route to one network 192.168.0.0, which is not that actually. It's not in our topology, but show one, I'm having one route for this network. 255.255.0.0 null 0. So any packets, see guys. Show run. Oh, I would have used a section command. See, IP route. I have got a static route. Okay. But if I do guys, show IP route. Can you see the route in your routing table? Yes. See, it says, is that connected? It's null 0. Null 0 is what? All packets for this network are going to be get dropped. Okay. Now, guys, I have to send these updates to my RIP updates, correct? So I'll say router RIP. I'll say redistribute static. Redistribute static means what? Send the static route in my RIP updates to all my RIP neighbors, correct? Enter. Done. I've done this, guys. Okay. Now that means on R2 I should receive the update of this route, correct? So let's go on R1. Show IP route. Do I see any new route for 192 network? No. Why guys? Any idea? Any guesses? Why? See, I did redistribute static, correct? R2 should now send this information to my neighbors. But it's not sending. R2 is sending but R1 is not receiving, something like that. So let's check for R2. First let's check R2. Is it sending or not? So what to do? Debug. IP RIP. Let's confirm first guys. Is my router R2 sending the update to my neighbors? See, sending version 1 updates. I'm sending on, so loopback on 1-1 I'm sending. But see, can you see guys, am I sending 192 updates anywhere? No. I'm not sending a 192, correct? Why? See guys, I'm sending version 1 updates, okay, but I'm sending only about network 10 and 209.232 and 228 I'm sending and receiving, correct guys? Let me stop this. So guys, R2 himself is not sending it. Where we have done all the procedure to do it, correct guys? We follow the procedure. We did this command and we did this command also, correct? It should be static, so we should send it. But actually he's not sending. Why? Yeah? Okay. I'll come to that part later, but let me explain some more stuff over here. R1 and R3 contain guys VLSM networks. Can you see guys? /24. See again? /24, /28. They all are VLSM networks, correct? Yeah? Subnets of these two. Over here, let's see guys. It's 200.32/28. Yeah? And 16 also over here, /28. Can you see guys? They are subnetted on VLSM networks, correct? Okay, now VLSM we know very well guys, just spend lots of time on VLSM. We did see your subnetting VLSM, so we will not go again back into deep. of this. Okay, so, and we know guys, private addresses you are very well now, 10 192 172 ranges from every class. Okay, now guys, what is happening over here? The loopback interface is, now we know guys very well, loopback interface, what is a logical interface, correct? Software running interface, just to emulate an interface. So we are making some loopbacks now. This thing we know very well guys. Okay, how to make a loopback we know very well now. Okay, then we did this stuff guys, remember we have done all this stuff. Okay, now guys, on R2 this is what happening. CIDR allows route aggregation, which is what, route summarization. A single high level route entry with a subnet marks less than the classful marks can be used to represent many lower level routes. So see guys, I had this network 0.0, 1.0 up to 25.0 slash 24. I have summarized them into slash 16, correct? And I am sending this into rip updates by redistributing, by doing the command redistribute static. But that is not happening guys, correct? And what is the benefit of this? Instead of having 255 routes, I am only having a single route, correct? That we saw in previously also in summarization, correct? Why we do summarization? The manual summarization guys. So I am summarized all 256 networks into a ranging from this to this into a single route, correct? Slash 16. Okay, but for lab purpose guys, we have just made this for lab purpose. Actually does not exist, but we are assuming that it is there. But that information, and we did this, I did these steps, correct? What is redistribution? Redistribution involves taking the routes from one routing source and sending those routes to another routing source, correct? So taking from static routes and sending them in rip routes, correct? That is called a redistribution. Now guys, this is just your CCNA level, but when you come to NP level, that will see about redistribution between, like if I got a network, for example, let me show my topology. Over here, I am running EIGRP. See guys, for here, I am running EIGRP and half of this part, I am running OSPF. So how can I make them converge to each other? You have to do redistribution, correct? Send EIGRP updates in route OSPF and send OSPF routes in EIGRP. Same way we can do between RIP and EIGRP, we can do between RIP and OSPF, yes. Same way now we did guys, you know, static and RIP we did just now. Why one way of default information origin command? Now we are doing via redistribute static. So guys, redistribution we will see in NP more in detail. But just here an idea of that for you, okay? So guys, routes can only be distributed into dynamic routing protocols, correct? Between dynamic or statics or directly connected, okay? Now guys, we did this thing, everything, correct? Now, is the static route being sent via RIP version 1 update over other RIP version 1 routes? And what I did now, this, is this happening? No, it's not happening, correct? RIP version 2, after doing all this stuff, is still not sending that update to my neighbor routers, correct? So, they're asking. We have to do redistribute, okay? We will see this, what is happening now. Okay. What do you expect when this happens? Ping. We saw this ping, remember guys? It was unreachable, sometimes it was pinging. We saw this before, remember guys? In the previous lab also we saw this. Yeah? Let me show you again. From R2, if I try to ping 172.30.1.1, unreachable. If I try to ping 2.1, it might ping. Might be ping. Yeah. Same way, if I ping .100.1, unreachable. Yeah guys, so if you see, it's not happening. Why? This issue because over here, what you saw, remember guys, from R1, can I ping 10.1.0.1? Yes, let's go on R1 guys. Can R1 ping 10 network 10.1.0.1? Yes. Can I ping 172.30.3.1? Yes. Sorry, 3.1 is not there, actually my mistake. 3.1 is not the in our topology, but guys, can I ping from here R1? Can I ping the loopback of R3? Let's try, see, this is 100.1, correct? Can I ping 100.1? What do you say guys? Will it happen? Ping? No, why? Because in my routing table, I don't have any entry for 100.1. 172.30, first two updates, it will match, okay. But when I see show IP route, see guys, I got only 2 and 1, can you see? Do I enter for 100.1? No, so I'm going to drop the packets on R1 itself. The packets are going to get dropped, correct? Yeah guys? So R1, I can ping this guy, this loopback, that's okay. But I can't ping this loopback, correct? Of R3. Same vice versa, R3 can ping this one, correct? Because of the issue with R2. RIP version 1 updates, I am receiving. R2 is receiving two updates, correct? One from R1, one from R3 for the same network they are showing, correct? 172.16.0.0, correct? Sorry, 172.30.0.0. But this is what is happening, correct guys, on R3 and R2, R1, same thing what we saw now. Now guys, RIP version 1 message format we saw very well, correct? it never sends the subnet mask. Okay, and these are things we have seen previously, guys. We know it very well. And this is a discontinuous network, correct? This is my discontinuous network topology. So what's happening? This is what happening, correct? Both are sending off 30.0011 hop, correct? So R2 is a little bit confused. This is what we saw on R2, correct, guys? See on R2. If I give show IP route command, yeah, this is what I can see. So guys, this is the problem with version 1 updates. Why? They don't send the subnet mask and other things. Let's see what are the problems. Whenever we debug IP rip, we saw this. I am sending and receiving. I saw this, correct, guys? I am receiving version 1 updates over this network from two neighbors. One by serial 0 and one by serial 01. Remember, guys, I show you in the previous lab also. And when I do show IP route on R1, I can see all about my networks 1 and 2. I can't see about the loopbacks of R3. Same way, vice versa. And remember, guys, this thing we have learned already. Okay. So, guys, we saw this stuff and we also saw how classful routing determines the subnet mask, correct? I showed you the full theory on that, guys. So, 30.00 major network boundary, correct? So, we make it slash 16, correct? Then you apply classful default mask. Why different network? Different classful major network. Apply default classful mask slash 16. Same way over here, correct, guys? Is applying slash 8. Over here, it is slash 24. Over here, it is slash something different. Slash 16, correct? Over here, again, different. So, I am combining them all and sending a slash 16. And guys, something more of VLSM over here, where no VLSM support again here also. When these updates come from here, let's see, guys, there for explanation part, I added one more router in this scenario. 30.100.0/24. So, when these updates come from this network to this R4, it will put slash 24. Why, guys? Same major network, correct? Same major network and the interface having the same interface and the updates belong to same major network. It is slash 24, correct? Remember as the theory which you saw last time. So this will be applied over here. Now, and one more function, guys, about CIDR. So we saw in our topology there is no VLSM support. And the CIDR support also. See, guys, I've added this thing, I've done this part, but still R2 is showing this route, static routes. Of course it goes to null 0, but it's not sending this route in RIP version 1 updates. Why? On R1, I'm not able to see the R1 is not receiving this update, correct? Yeah, guys, from R2, R1 is not receiving the update for this static route. Why? See, we did this debug also. I showed you this stuff. Remember, guys? I showed you debug. And R2 himself is not sending it. So, how will R1 receive? When R2 is not sending, how can he receive? Why is not sending? Because the problem is the static route is class C and is showing a slash 16, correct? This is a fewer bits than the class full of class C mass of slash 24, correct? And being RIP version is a class full routing protocol, it cannot support CIDR format, correct? And that's the summarized routes with the smaller subnet marks than the actual subnet marks of the route, correct? If it was slash 24, it was slash 24, it was 1 more 255 over here, then he must have sent it. But it's slash 16, so he himself can't understand it. So R2 himself can't understand slash 16 marks for one and two network. That's why he's not sending two version my neighbor R1 and R3. Understanding, guys? Very first problem with RIP version 1 is a class pool. We say RIP version 1 doesn't support VLSM, doesn't support CIDR. That's what his CIDR format, he doesn't understand. He's not sending it. Understanding? So RIP version 1 ignores his supernets in the routing table and does not include them in your updates to the other routers. Understanding? He's ignoring them, he's not understanding. Why? If it was 255.0, he would have sent it. Understanding? So this is because the receiving router would not be able to apply the larger slash 24 classful marks to the update and not the shorter slash 16 marks. That's the issue over here. So what to do? Otherwise convey this as slash 24 marks, correct? To send. But still we can do it. How? RIP version 2. Who supports CIDR, who supports VLSM. So what to do? Same topology we are having, guys. Now let's see what's the difference in version 2 and version 1 packet header. The message formats. Of course, command 1 and 2 you remove, guys, for reply and response. Version 1 for RIP version 1. Version 2 for RIP version 2. Now see, guys, these are unused fields, remember, guys? Now route tag, this is a new concept, guys. This will see in CCNP. Okay, guys, where you see the redistribution part, route tag. Okay, but what I'm doing, guys, the field which are unused, we are using the same fields for RIP version 2. Now guys, this time I am going to send a subnet mask. See, I am using this field for subnet mask. And the another a new spiel I'm using for next of IP address. So version 2 is going to add your subnet mask in the routing updates, and also going to send a next of IP address. Understanding, guys? So this is the difference. Of course, maximum I will send 25 routes in one update, one message of RIP. That's okay, that's same. And RIP version 2 allows guys both CRDN and VLSN to be used. So how to enable RIP version 2? Very simple. Just go and give the command version 2 on your router. See? Okay. Now guys, a very important concept which I want to talk with you over here. So guys, we just saw the difference between the packets message format of RIP version 1 and version 2. So version 2 is going to send a subnet mask with the routing updates and the next hop also. So how to configure version 2? Very simple. But before that guys, what version we are running currently? We say it's RIP version 1, correct? Let me show you guys. How to check which version you are working? Show IP protocols. The protocol I'm running is RIP. My sending updates after every 30 seconds, next DOR in my 21 seconds. Invalid timer guys, I showed you everything, hold on timer, all it is, we've seen this stuff, plus timer. Now see guys, default version control, I'm sending version 1, can you see guys? But it says I can receive any version. I'm running RIP version 1 currently, but I can receive any version. Means what? I can receive, see here. And on what are the interfaces which are RIP is enabled? My serial interface and my two loopbacks on R1. And all these three interfaces can send version 1 and they can receive version 1 and 2 both. So guys, you are getting guys what I want to show you guys. Like this version, he is sending version 1 updates. He can receive version 1 as well as version 2 updates also. So for example, if this router is running RIP version 1 and if he is running RIP version 2, will this R1 receive the updates from RIP version 2 R2? Yes. Okay. But if I make version 2 over here, what will happen after that? Will this guy will be able to receive version 1 updates? We'll see later. We'll see this later. Okay guys, see what I'm saying now guys. So guys, you know, I'll not say this is RIP version 1 pure. I will say this is RIP version 1.5. This is RIP version 1.5. Why? He can receive version 2 also. If I want to make it version 1 compulsorily, just give the command router RIP and I will say version 1. Don't do this guys, but I'm just showing you to make you understand the concept. Do show IP protocols. See now guys. Now this is actually pure RIP version 1. What we are doing till now, it was RIP version 1.5 actually. See guys, in the real world, in theory, we never see in books, it is RIP version 1.5 actually. But actually we say it's RIP version 1. But he has got a behavior where he can send and receive version 1 packets, but he can receive version 2 also. So it is actually RIP version 1.5. Just to say guys. Actually version 1, see guys, you can only send and receive version 1 packets, can you see guys? What is triggered and keychain, we'll see this later in the next lecture, but see guys. Now see the difference. I can send and receive only RIP version 1. So this is now pure RIP version 1. And see here he was able to receive any version, correct? Now guys, if I want to go back to normal, what to do? Just type no version. No version, okay? So see now. Now I'm back to normal. Now I am again RIP version 1, but this time I can receive version 2 updates also. Okay guys, so understood this concept? Okay. Then something more like, I hope so, I showed you this last time. Remember guys, maximum paths 4, what are they? Maximum 4 equal cost load balancing. 4 paths, if I am having the same destination, I can do load balancing. Automatic summarization is in effect, yes. These are networks which I am advertising, and this is my gateway through which I am going to my getting the updates, correct? And the AD values and all this stuff. So guys, default RIP version 1 when configuring RIP. So router only sends RIP version 1 messages, but he can process both, correct, receives. But he ignores RIP version 2 fields in the route entry. Okay, we'll see this later. And RIP version 2 will ignore RIP version 1 updates. How? I'll show you after some time. So guys, how to configure RIP version 2? Same way I showed you like how to configure RIP version 1, correct? Just type version 2, R1. So let's run other routers. R2 also, NFT, router. RIP version 2 and R3 also, router RIP version 2. So now guys, what is the first difference that you would like to see after doing this? Let's go on R1 only and just check. If I give the command now, show IP protocols, see guys, very first difference, version 2. I can send version 1, I can receive version 2, and see guys, send receive. So guys, if I make a scenario where this guy is working with RIP version 1 and if working on version 2, see, I'm saying pure version 1. So he will send only rip version 1, version 2, version 1 updates. So he can't understand version 1 updates. He will send version 2 updates. He can't understand version 2 updates. Okay. If it was rip 1.5, rip 1.5, only rip, normal rip, he can understand rip version 1. He can send rip version 1, but he can understand received version 2, correct? But he can't understand rip version 1. So how to make a communication between them? That, guys, is a part of CCNP, but I'll show you in the next lecture. Okay? That's a different story. But understood, guys, now what is happening? Okay. Let's see the routing table. Show IP route. Oh, I saw some more updates over here. Can you see, guys? See the first update. The /16 SuperNet. I received it. Why? It supports CIDR format. Who? Rip version 2. It supports VLSI. But guys, what about? What about 30.100 and 200? I'm not getting R3 loopbacks. Am I able to see the R3 loopback interfaces on R1? No, not yet. But I see the first change, what about this network? Yeah, let's go on R3. Show IP route. Yes, here also I saw the static route, guys. I say it's coming via rip updates, correct? So now R2 in short is sending these routes, correct? Let's go on R2 and let's do a debug. Now in debug, guys, we'll come to know some more features, correct? Debug IP. Let's make it full screen and let's see what is sending now, guys. What is sending now and what is receiving? The very first difference that you get to see, guys, you know, let me see, is there any debug? Okay, these are the previous debug. See, guys, in the previous debug, was there any netmask over here? See, no netmask, correct? And sending updates on which address? Okay, the first difference I'll show you. And see, the updates here were broadcasted. Can you see, guys? Here it was broadcast. Can you see 255.255? Over here, the updates are multicast. See the IP address of multicast. What it is? 224.0.0.9. Second thing, it's sending version 2 updates. Can you see, guys? And see how it is showing /16, /30. Can you see, guys? /8. Yeah? It's showing the CIDR values. Okay. See the tag value. You know, guys, the tag which came into picture now? But as I told you, this tag comes into picture when you see talk about CCNP level course, okay? That time you see the value tag is used for actually, okay? Some external information is related to this tag, okay? Now guys, can you see something? Received version 2 update. So it's receiving this 30.0.16 via two different interfaces, but again, what is happening? They're summarizing, correct? Yes, it's receiving a summarized route. Let me stop this. It's going high now. So it's sending, guys, the version 2 updates on multicast address first of all. Yeah, guys, and see the next option. You see, guys, the next option information and via which interface, okay? Yeah, now, guys, it's showing the netmask, yeah, and it's getting this update via two routes, correct? Okay, guys, saw the difference. What are after doing rip version 2? Guys, version 2 command, you've done it. Yeah, we saw this. We also saw this version 1 after doing version 1. What happens after doing version 1? Yeah, so we are, but guys, on R2 still shows what? R2 still showing me what? In show IP route. Still shows me this thing, yeah. It's still getting two routes, correct? Means two routes to have the same network. So how to stop that? That is because auto summary, correct? It is getting summarized. So how to stop the auto summarization? See, guys, again, this /16 we understood, we got it, correct? Now this R1 and R3 still do not include these networks, okay? But the only difference so far we saw, he received this CIDR value format, correct? The static route configured on R2 is issued into RIP now, correct? I'm sending the CIDR values, okay. But when you see debug IP rip, you still see rip version 2 is sending both the network's address as subnet mask, but it's still summarizing them, correct? It's still summarizing these two routes into one route, correct? These four loopbacks into one network. Still happening. So how to do? Disable summarization, correct? We saw this, guys, summarization is in effect, correct? But if rip version 2 automatically summarizes at the major network boundaries, same like rip version 1. So this same thing is happening over here. So what to do? Disable the summarizations. How? Just use the command no auto summary. Okay. So connect router rip and just use the command no auto summary. Okay. R2 connect router rip no auto summary. Okay. Same way R3 connect router rip no auto summary. That's it. show IP route. What you can expect to see now? See the routing table going bigger. These are my connected routes. Okay. Can you see the RIP routes? Can you see the more RIP routes? 1.0.30, 2 and 1 over here. Now see guys, previously what you should say guys. If you see the old routing table, it is there visible over here somewhere. And let's go on the other router, R1. You can see if you have to see the old table and new table. See, first you are saying this is subnet into two subnets. Two subnets means having the same net mask, correct? Now if I give the command do show IP route, what it says? This slash 16 is variably subnetted into 6 subnets and 2 masks. He has got total 6 children. This panel has got 6 children, out of which some are girls, some are boys. 2 masks, correct? 2 genders. See here. Slash 28, 28, and the rest all are slash 24. You see guys, 2 net masks, correct? Half, 2 are having slash 28 net masks and some are having slash 24 net masks. Understanding guys? So now, am I getting all the RIP updates? Yes. Why? We are disabled the summarization. And if I give the command show IP protocols, what it says? What they say? Automatic summarization is not in effect. We have disabled the automatic summarization. Okay. So show IP route. I can see the loopbacks of my R3. Yes. Now can I ping 172.30.100.1? Yes. Very fine now. Yeah, guys. And what about R2? What about R2? If I go on R2. What should I expect to see now? Here it was showing us 2 routes, correct? Yeah guys, what do you expect to see now? Show IP route. See, different. See, for, okay, he's saying here. Now see guys, see the update timer. 2 minutes, 17 seconds. So, he has never heard for this route. Why? Because now R1 and R3 are not sending any updates for this network. They are sending for individual networks. So you see guys, we have disabled summarization. So if you just keep on up arrow key, after 3 minutes, this information has to be get removed automatically from the routing table, correct guys? No, it will say possibly down. Then after 240 seconds, that is 4 minutes, this information will get removed. See guys, as I get the updates, this keep on refreshing, see. If I get the updates, see 11 seconds before I got updates, correct? And see now, 1016, it's 2 minutes 57 seconds. See, it went, it says possibly down, can you see guys? Yeah, this concept I am going to explain in the next lecture in a very more detailed manner. But see, that information with the old information has been gone now. If we should do again, no more information of 16. See, it's possibly down still yet. It's possibly down, okay. 240 seconds, 4 minutes, correct? Possibly down. Wait for some more seconds. It's possibly down. Show IP protocols. Okay, it's coming. It's possibly down still. It will go after some time from your routing table. So this information is showing as possibly down. It will automatically get removed from your routing table. Okay, after the flush timer. Still not happening. It should go actually. But see the routes guys. Now R2 has got route for 200 via 234. And for 1.0 via 230. Can you see guys? Yeah. Yeah guys, can you see the routes? See, for 1 and 2 is via 230. See guys, gone. That updates, that 16 has been gone, correct? Plus timer is gone. Now, can you see the difference guys between version 1 and version 2? It supports CIDR, so I send these updates to my neighbor routers. It supports VLSM and I did no auto summary. I can see now all the routes. See? And I am sending subnet masks in my routing updates, correct? Each and every subnet mask, correct? Understanding guys? So this is the benefits of your RIP version 2 over RIP version 1. So guys, still here, any queries? I saw these updates, yes, on R1, R2, R3, we saw this stuff, we debug IPD, we saw, it's sending version 2 updates, yeah, and what is the multicast address of version 2? 224.009, okay, so, and VLSM and CIDR also, we saw this stuff very well now, guys. So any queries today, guys, yeah, tag also, I told you, we see later, and you also saw it's 16, it's advertising there, correct? For the supernet to be included in the routing update, the routing protocol must have the capability of carrying the mask, correct? So it's carrying this slash 16 mask, that's why it's showing in my routing protocol. So RIP version is a classless routing protocol, correct? Well, see, this is classless, correct? Different class, we have broken the class, I'm sending it, correct? Yeah guys, we saw this stuff, everything. So any queries here guys, till here? And troubleshooting is very simple, guys. Just you have to play with the concepts. Show IP route, show IP interface. We see this last time also, you know, guys, in the RIP version 1 troubleshooting. Show IP protocol, see what type of version you are using, what you are receiving, and what is the RIP enabled, what is summarization happening, is it in effect or not, okay, and what networks you are advertising. So, debug commands, these are some basic commands, guys, to debug or you can troubleshoot your RIP routing protocol, okay. And now the ping was working fine, okay. And guys, version 1 and version 2 can be made compatible with additional commands, but we'll see this in the next lecture, guys, okay. And network command does two things. What? When I type in the router RIP and give the network command, it enables the routing protocol to send and receive updates on that interface, correct? It belongs to the network. Remember, I repeat this thing from my first lecture of RIP. And it includes the configure network in its routing updates to the neighbor routers, correct? So this is what you see, guys. And what might be some mistakes, like if you do some incorrect typing errors, that all we can troubleshoot, correct? Okay, guys. And automatic summarization, again, need to take care. If you disable it, how to disable? No auto summary. What are benefits of summarization? Yes, small routing table. But you see, in our scenario, it's cumbersome. R2 is confused. Where to go? Okay. So any queries here? So guys, now next lecture, I'm going to show you the authentication of RIP. Then you see load balancing via RIP, and I'm going to show you RIP version 1 and version 2 compatibility. Okay. That's not part of your CCNA course, but I'm going to teach you. So we'll see that time later. Okay. In the next lecture, guys. So till here, any queries, any doubts? RIP version 1, version 2, we saw the features, okay.